In this video, we're going to demonstrate request templates with the batch controller. Request templates allow us to create a set of sub-requests with dynamic URLs for multiple sub-requests based on the template. Let's say you need to select multiple JSON path tokens. So, if you have an array of elements or attributes, and we might need to create a sub-request for each one of those. We can use request templates to do this. We'll use the request template property in our subrequest in conjunction with the parent ID and the parameters fields that we learned about in the previous video. Nested in here is going to be a resource property, which we will fill out in the same manner as we did before, using the string substitution with JSON path selecting the parameter. However, this time the parameters will have an array. Rather than selecting one object, we'll be selecting them all. Let's get started with an example. In my parent subrequest, I'm going to request all of the equipment with the AF template, boiler. We can see from the response that it's returning a number of elements under the content.items object in the response. In order to select all of these, we'll need to use some new JSON path syntax. We'll use brackets and an asterisk in order to reference all of the objects in that items array. Now, let's make our child subrequest. I want to get the current value for all attributes on any boiler elements, so we'll be using the StreamSets controller. We have a get method, with the parent ID being our query for boiler elements request. Next, we'll need to use that request template parameter, and encased in the brackets of this is going to be a resource parameter. This resource will be our URL /PyWebAPI/StreamSets/, here is where our web ID is going to go. Since we'll be retrieving it via the parameters field, I'll put in a curly brace and a zero. And lastly, since we want the current value, we'll finish the URL with /value. Again, let's take a look at the response for just the parent request here that I ran earlier. I made this request specifically so I could see the response and identify the path with JSON path. It looks like to get the web IDs of these elements, I'll need to go under Content, then Items, and select the web ID property. Our parameters field then ends up looking like so. We use the asterisk after the items property to let the PyWebAPI know that we would like to get the web ID property for all items in the array. When we send this, we expect to see a subresponse for each web ID in the array. Looking at the response, we can see it's quite large. It's also returning to us all of the attributes that were returned in the query for boiler elements subrequest. An important thing to note looking at this response is that each of these sub-responses based on the request template are returned as the content of a single sub-response. Request templates are a powerful tool to help you retrieve all the information you need very quickly. It's important to keep in mind, though, you can potentially be making hundreds or even thousands of sub-requests using the template when you're selecting all of the items in an array, so please be careful when using this tool.